Allow the meeting to be held, consider the outstanding issues, one of which is the financial report and the recruitment of general managers. And given the fact that COOP is the largest employees organization, it will not be represented during that process. And that might not be in the interest of the employees. No, who's going to be the general manager is also very critical.
It would appear that the court will nominate two members of
yes, to send himself, that is from the concerning the gender, then according to the provisions of the act, there is lack of quorum. And that also is not good for the organization. Because COTU and FKE must be present for the meeting of NSSF to take place, even if all the members are present. But one member from one of those organizations is not present, then there is lack of quorum. It was done so because the NSSF is maintained by the employers and the employees, not the government. So in this case, because as a result of that, we are requesting the court to intervene and grant us, that's the prohibitory orders, at this stage. Yes.
Certainly,
because of the letter that was written. There is a letter there where the cabinet secretary has gone on a fishing expedition when he does not have the authority. In fact, he has breached the statutory provision of section 6(d)(2). And we have to quash that letter. And I know, my lord, at this stage, I'm not asking for certiorari. I'm only asking for a prohibition because the event has not happened. You cannot prohibit what has happened. No, A, that is one, to be certified agent and leave. Once leave is granted, you can have
specific prayers 1 and 2.
Yes, ma'am. 2A.
At this stage, I can grant you leave, isn't it?
Yes, you can grant.
All these orders of you as you pray. So is it that you are saying the grant of leave to operate as a stay, or what are you saying?
Yes, the grant of leave can act as a stay.
In terms of what prayer?
In terms of prayer A.
urgent, and service therefore is dispensed with in the first instance. Leave is granted to the expert applicant, the Central Organization of Trade Unions, COTU, to apply for judicial review orders of prohibition, saturari, mandamus, and as paid for in prayer 2A, B, and C of the Chamber Summons. The leave granted for prayer 2A in the Chamber Summons do operate as a stay restraining the first respondent by himself or through his authorized servants or agents, namely the NSSF Board of Trustees, the interested party herein, from convening any board meeting pending the gazettement and appointment of the ex parte applicants woman nominee to the board, the substantive notice of motion pursuant to the leave granted herein be fined and served upon the respondents and the interested party, together with all the papers filed herein, not later than 16 July 2018, with a hearing date given at the registry on urgency basis, and not later than 14 days from today. The course of the application shall abide the outcome of the intended substantive judicial review application.
Yeah, the cameras.
Yes.
Just like, his antennas are very high. Huh?
Digital.
Very digital.
Yeah.
I love that.
Turn the bus. Tell us, you know, what you came to seek from the court.
The basis of the application of today was to, one, direct the Cabinet Secretary in charge of Labour, Social Security and Services to appoint and gazette the Central Organization of Trade Unions, COTU's nominee to the board of the National Social Security Fund. The Act provides that in terms of Section 6D2, COTU, being one of the largest employees organization, to nominate two people, one female, one male. So the female has been nominated and the name forwarded to the minister to appoint and gazette by a letter written on 5th of March 2018. The minister never responded to that letter. Another letter was written on 8th of June 2018. The minister failed to respond. We also wrote a letter to the minister urging him to gazette, to appoint and gazette. He failed to respond to that letter up to date. Instead, what he did by his letter of 5th of July 2018, he wrote to COTU in response to COTU's letter of 8th of June 2018 that he is still scrutinizing the recommendation of COTU whether it is in compliance with the Constitution and regional balance. Our position is, and the position of the law, the minister does not have such power. He does not have the authority to scrutinize the recommendation that has been given by COTU in terms of Section 6D2 that I've alluded to. So he has acted beyond his powers, and now we want that letter also to be quashed, and that is the we have applied for the certiorari. Now the court has restrained the NSSF board from any meetings. They cannot convene or call for any meeting until the gazettement is done because the minister has breached. In fact, it's an abuse of power. He has breached the statutory provisions. Instead, he has gone on a fishing expedition trying to catch fish where fish does not exist. So that is the basis of the application that we have brought today, and the court has awarded us order 1-2A. Yes, that is, he has satisfied the application agent, he has granted us leave, and he has also prohibited any meeting that may be convened by NSSF. Okuya Chendo, an advocate of the High Court of Kenya.